Like a bell cut.
Hey, what's up, guys? Prom here. Welcome to Monster Prom. This is a Halloween. Valentine's Day special. I almost said Halloween. Oh, we're in the middle of February. And I'm saying because it's Halloween. Anyways, this is Monster Prom. It's essentially a monster dating game. Where you are a monster that goes to prom, and well, you have to find a partner to go to prom, and it could be one of these many people that you may see in the background. So, yeah, I say we get started. This is also a multiplayer dating game, but we're gonna go with one player because, well, one, I'm on my own, and two, quarantine and everything. And there's the first turn, which is the classic, and this is the second turn DLC, which adds a couple more characters in first turn, but we're going to stick with first turn for now. And you can choose whether you want to have like a short game that lasts like 30 minutes or you want like a full game that lasts 60 minutes. I'm going to just go with a short game, 30 minutes, because you know, I don't have all day. So we're just going to get down to it. And yes, I have got in control. Spooky high school, the sweetest years of our lives. Back then, we were young and unafraid, sometimes reckless, sometimes brilliant, sometimes just stupid, but always willing to live life to the fullest. We were on a wild journey to discover who we really were. So this is the part where you get to choose our character. You can get through one of these. So I propose to be playing as this guy for most of my playthroughs, but I've been trying this out off camera. Or I've had this game for like at least 2 days, downloaded it from the eShop. I'm gonna go with Shadow Boy here. You can just call him the color clothing. You can just, you know, or you can come up with a custom name. You know, I'm just gonna go with what I've usually been doing, so give myself a custom name. I'll use the lowercase because apparently everyone else I've seen play this game puts their full name in capitals. Like, come on, guys, have you actually went to school before? And you can also change your pronouns, he, she, they, whatnot, so we're just going to keep it a he. I also should probably mention, before we get any further, that this is a 16 game. There's probably going to be a lot of, like, heavy topics, stuff that may not be suitable for children, so I will definitely make sure to do that when I upload this. But, anyways, back on track. And we had yet to experience its ultimate challenge, the Monster Prom. I remember it clearly. 3 weeks were left as we fantasized about our dream prom dates. We were all scrambling to catch the attention of one of our six most charismatic classmates. Miranda Vanderbilt, 19, a sweet mermaid princess who was as cute as she was genocidal. Damien LaVey, age 21, a fearless demon with a taste for destruction and a love for fire. He was also voiced by Nate Wants to Battle. Scott Howe, 21, a werewolf athlete who compensated for his rather small brain with a stupidly huge heart. He was also voiced by Aaron Hansen, aka Eagle Raptor, aka Aaron from Game Grumps. Liam DeLioncourt, 400-something, a hipster vampire whose standoffish demeanor hit that he was a truly lovable dork. Polyguise, 22, a party ghost with an insatiable hunger for all the wrong things. And Vera Oberlin, 23, a mean self-made Gorgon with a merciless sense of business, and also the girl I've constantly been trying to get in the date, but I finally got her after like 6 tries. It was very exhausting. But we're not gonna go for her, because trying to get her was already hard enough. You gotta get like these real specifics for some of these things, guys. It was clear it had to be one of them, but who? We only had 3 weeks to choose our prom date, and even more daunting, we had 3 weeks to woo them and conquer their heart. As I already said, we were young and unafraid, and we were ready to start. Alright. So this thing here is just a little thing that, like, asks you, like, a bunch of questions, and gives you, like, different stats, turn into stats. So I'm just gonna fill that out off camera for you guys, so we can get into the actual game.
So now I picked the stats. We also have a 3-week deadline, which obviously we chose
That'd be for a short game. As you can see, there's different. These are kind of like where you get like different stats. You can kind of see up on the top right corner. You've got smarts, boldness, creativity, charm, fun, and money. So we can go to like any of these places you want and just kind of like do stuff there. Your auditorium, class, library, outdoors, gym, and bathrooms. I think we'll start with my favorite place. We'll start with the auditorium. This is a really nice place I like. Haha, it's beautiful. Oh, look. That day, while rehearsing for the class play, it's as though the muses themselves have descended to give you compliments. Your performance is intense and inspiring. It'll be remembered for generations. It's pretty rad by high school play standards. You gain +2 creativity. Later that night, you head out to the club with Polly and Liam. Using your fake ID is also known as Polly. You have no problem getting to the door. The real trouble begins when you get to the bar, and Polly starts teasing Liam.
I'm telling you, boy, you've got no game.
And I'm telling you that I reject the paradigm underlying your assertion.
All I'm saying is that you're really cool, as you really as cool as you act all the time. You should have no problem getting hits from that locus swarm down at the end of the bar.
Well, of course I could, but I want to. But you see, the key to my allure is that I don't want anything. Sounds to you like Liam's scared. You decide to go over there and show them both how it's done. But coating your insect pheromones. Don't go after people. People go after dancing so hard that you also separate in a cloud of locusts. I'm not sure what this is. The go for. This one? You pull out your spray bottle of locust pheromones that you keep for such occasions. You search it all over the most intimate air. The hot young one at the other end of the bar immediately takes notice. You talk all night about your hopes and dreams. Turns out the locust pheromone wants to be a. I don't know what that means. When you excuse yourself to go to the bathroom, Leon catches you by the arm. Hey, not that I care about anything, but do you think you can learn from that locust pheromone? No reason. Looks like Leon got a thing for locusts. You gain +2 charm and +1 smarts. And then noon is where you go. Is where you're at the lunch. You hang out at the lunch table with all the cool people. Got all these people here. So far we're gonna be hanging out with Liam for this run, which I think I can kind of calm myself. You know, I was kind of playing more casually because the last few times I was kind of intense because I was focusing on Vera. But yeah. Liam and Polly aren't alone at the table. They're flanked by two beefy hobgoblins in school security uniforms. What, do these two have bodyguards now? They aren't bodyguards, they're food guards. I forgot to mention this. I went into the options before recording. I went into options and put this like these characters kind of like different costumes, so you can kind of just have like mix and match. So that's kind of why Liam's kind of dressed as sex vampire here. It's probably like a Halloween costume he's got or something. So in case you see any of these characters wearing like outlandish, like crazy uniforms, that's probably why. They aren't bodyguards, they're food guards. Principal Giant Spider found out we weren't eating during lunch, so he assigned guards to us because he thinks we have an eating disorder. And we do have an eating disorder. It's called being dead. I mean, true, Liam's a vampire and Polly's a ghost. I mean, vampires don't necessarily need to eat in order to live, as far as I'm concerned. And then go a ghost, so the food kind of goes right through them. Except it's not an eating disorder, it's an identity and a lifestyle. Death style. Whatever, the point is that they won't let us leave until we eat our food. Which will be never. And I have a meeting of the Smoke Superiority Club to conduct next period. I can't be late. If you just figured out a way around these food guards for us, I'd be super grateful. Like, in a cool way. Well, I can't say no to that. Time to accept your fiendishly clever plan. Dump all of Polly's food onto Liam's plate. Dump all of Liam's food onto Polly's plate. This will help out Polly, I think. And this will help out Liam, I think. Well, since we're kind of going with Liam, I think I'm gonna have to go with this option. Hopefully it's the right one. With all the artistic subtlety of performance artist Marina Ambram, you pour Liam's suit onto Polly's plate. And threw her that.
No, this is literally the exact opposite of what I wanted.
Good lord, what a tableau. I go through the world to buy a mountain of unwanted food. That's perhaps my most daring food pick, yeah. Oh yeah, he also likes to take food pictures. I mean, he's a hipster, but you guys are really throwing me under the bus here, which isn't cool, because being thrown under a bus is totally how I died. I don't know what you're talking about, Polly. I have clearly consumed all my food, quite honestly, and forthrightly. That face, it's like when the smart guy in anime does the thing with his glasses. He's like, yes, I figured you out. Luckily for you and Liam, the Hobgoblins are totally morons, and no secondary theory of mind fancy they believe Liam's ruse. Liam whisks away to where you spend smug superiority class, where you spend hours practicing your sneers and gazing into each other's eyes. And then evening. And just in case you guys may be wondering about what this cat is, this is a lady that gives you, like, it's a shop where you can buy stuff and all that. I don't really need much for, now I do need to increase my boldness, but the cat's at the bathroom, and if you go to the bathroom, you gain boldness. So, the only other stat I can kind of work on right now is my money, so we can go to the library and do that. Cool. That day you spend most time in the library, he's managing your start ticker, like a Kickstarter. This game has a lot of jokes. You can see lots of people with a sensationalist video and impossible promises. Like, you gain 100,000 money, but almost everything goes to cover costs, and you have to go and collect your money. But Liam is paying attention to any of that. He corners you afterwards to lecture you on Instagram filters. And he's just in a summer uniform. Totally casual. And he's got a bite mark in his arm. Thought he became a vampire? Probably. What no one seems to understand about filters is that they're not about making pictures better. They're about making pictures browner and harder to see. That's why my own proprietary filter. I don't know how to say that word. My own filter. For almost all my filters. Infinite total. It's also probably why I only have 6 Instagram followers, but we all must make sacrifices for our art. In any case, I have to go. There's a dead rat in the parking lot. I simply must document. As soon as Liam's gone, Miranda peeks out of an air conditioned. Why is the fish girl in here? Get this. The situation is even more dire than I thought. If Operation Make Liam Popular Again is to succeed, we must get started immediately. What's that? Why, it's of course you're part of my operation. I am willingly force people into my service all the time. Because I'm a genocidal mermaid princess, and Daddy wants me to do that job. Oh, you want to know why the operation made me look against? Well, you've been alive for like centuries, right? I'm sure it must have been popular at some point. I'll check his history books later. There's no time now. Phase one is getting Liam more Instagram followers. I took the liberty of having my royal spies discover the password to his account, so we can give it a total makeover. But what to do? Use his account to post a bunch of off-brand and bomb recipes. Pay a million homeless people to follow Liam on Instagram. I mean, this might work for Liam, maybe. I don't know. So what? Ah, yes, this is Father paid millions to vote for him in our fair and democratic election, which is basically totally not like Putin in Russia. Vladimir Putin. I actually forgot his name. Guys, don't judge me. I'm from Europe, okay? I'm in UK. I'm not from Russia. In fact, I think I could cut costs by paying one of Father's clone smiths to simply replicate the same 1,000 people 1,000 times. Yes, Miranda, she thinks this is ethical. But she's just confused at the meaning of ethics as she is about fair and democratic elections. Doing the plot and the record clones are hatched. You run into Liam in the hall a few hours later. I am distraught. My carefully abandoned unpopularity is crumbling before my eyes. Look at all these followers. Look at that comments. Talk to the real account 66. I love you, Liam. I know that equally real account. You're so obscure and a fine God. The sentiments they're expressing are objectively correct. And yet, no. I cannot give in to the lure of the limelight. In spite of this, Liam seems to be enjoying himself quite a bit. Spend the rest of the day helping him curate his feed, gaining +2 charm, +1 fun. Morning. This is week 2. So let's head to the bathroom to gain more boldness. That day, skip class and just hang out in the bathroom because you respect no authority. Aw, look at the little shadows. He's in the air style. That's cute. I guess the people just want to watch the world burn. By skipping class and hanging out in the bathroom, you give 0 damn, but you gain +2 boldness. After you finish doing your business, you hear a commotion, and next stop. It would be polite to just ignore it and move on. Unfortunately, a cave troll taught you matters, so you kick the door open. Miranda and Liam are huddled with some bathroom graffiti, and they seem confused. Maybe it's the password to a highly exclusive event. But why do people aren't smart enough to figure it out? And why make it secret? Well, obviously, they don't want outsiders to get in. Father's beard? That's how it starts.
What starts?
The revolution. They are having a coup.
No, it's probably like a party or something.
Parties? That's exactly what revolutions are about. I'm too young to have a revolution.
You're not sure why the friend of piece of passing so important, but this is a great opportunity to impress them both. You confidently tell them. Isn't it obvious? It's an exclusive download code for the internet's holiday multimedia dating thing. Human Prom. That's Polly's number.
I'm not sure about this. I don't know, guys. Honestly, I don't know. But, I'm thinking maybe... I mean, the human problem thing, that sounds kind of neat. But, I don't know. I mean, Polly's number? I don't know. I don't know what... I can't tell what the graffiti looks like. But I'm assuming it's just a bunch of numbers, so, try this one?
yourself and really Miranda listened with breathless attention as he explained the gripping premise of Human Prom. Up to four friends like dynamic human avatars that compete to win the affection of one of six quirky humans. It's basically Monster Prom, but without the monsters. You know how to conquer a human's heart? Winky face. Miranda stops hyperventilating. Liam's eyes go wide with admiration. You take a breath. It was a long story, and he told it all without breathing for some reason. My word, you're right. It's a QR code. I didn't recognize it because no one ever uses those. It's so indie. It's like finding a game of a game itself. A game within a game. It's so innovative. I must play it immediately. Wait, make sure it's not a revolutionary VR game. Liam runs to the library with super vampires. And Miranda follows him to make sure he doesn't do anything super. Little does Liam know, this game within a game is within this game. Also, you've got a game. New game plus two fun plus one smart. There's just so much. This is literally Inception right now. Oh, it's actually.
So kind of just missed over some just a lunch where Scott was where the werewolf guy was cheering on Liam to take a food pick. Liam was kind of getting annoyed, so I used the art of mime to put Liam in a box, and me and Liam just moved to a table and put Scott in a box. Then Liam, I went to a different table to eat, and he tagged me in his photo. I think our relationship's going good so far. Afterwards, Miranda beckons you from the bar. Co-conspirator, here, over here. Phase 1 of Operation Make Liam Popular Again was an overwhelming success. Liam is internet popular. Now we just need to make him real life popular. What better way than making him? Prom King! Fortunately, when I asked him to run for Prom King, he said, as I quote, never, 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 not in 100 years, and that's not an exaggeration, because I've been alive for hundreds of years, and I've never run for Prom King, so there you go. Which is clearly his cryptic way of saying he wants us to make him Prom King. My first vote was to murder the current Prom King after his action with Liam and his rightful heir, but I couldn't find any bloodline choice for it. So I suppose you must engage in this democratic election the school is holding. Now how can we secure a win for Liam when he's opposed to running or me in any effort to win? I'll dress up as Liam and give the best campaign speech anyone has. Pay a million people to vote for Liam for Prom King. Of course, money is the way to go. I don't think he would be happy with me dressing up as him. Especially considering that I'm a shadow person. So we can go with the money. Of course, election rigging, silly me house. Well, someone else will be charismatic if you know how to hire a million voters. Sure you do, totally. You got lots of money in connection. You don't run, you'll get right on them. Luckily, what you lack in money and collect. In stolen magical artifacts. You put on your robe and with your hat, crack open a forbidden tube. You got all schools of janitorial equipment to light. You can't help but the janitor's coffin. Passing out bows to broomsticks and telling mop buckets to the boat. Nobody notices the fraud. Half the student body is sent to be in optics anyway. Senior role was prompting the election broke out together and... I can't believe it! 6,000 votes from me, and 900... I heard 994,000 votes for a bottle of lemon-scented toilet bowl cleaner. I'd be impressed that they even got it. It's a student body. If I wasn't so comprehensively humiliated. Nice going, now you can find a tuxedo that fits a bottle of lemon scent. The other is minus 2 charm and minus 3. Damn it. I thought it was gonna work, but I guess it didn't. Morning. Time to go to the gym. That day, an epic dodgeball match takes place. Everything seems lost, but you deliver an inspirational speech that fuels your team's spirit, leading to a spectacular comeback. You're clearly a natural-born leader. You gain plus 2 charm, which is now my highest stat. Scott strolls by, happily munching on something. Liam gapes at him, appalled. What on earth are you eating, Scott?
This delicious new flavor of Fangles potato chips. Maximum ultimate double barbecue mess.
Really? Because it looks like a raw severed goat head inside a cardboard tube.
Oh, yeah, I guess it does. Could have sworn it was potato chips. Silly date. Still tasty, though.
Tasty? Tasty? Does wanton environmental destruction sound tasty to you?
I don't know. Is that a kind of jerky?
No, Scott, don't you realize that in order to harvest these goat heads, Fangles and decapitate millions of innocent goats every year?
But what do they do with the bodies of the goats?
Nothing. It's a horrendously wasteful practice.
And I just love Scott's face. This guy's just like, what?
Oh no, all those poor headless goats' bodies running around and bumping into things. We have to stop them.
Wait, really? I was just trying to make you feel guilty. I didn't actually have a plan of action, but if someone would suggest one. Assemble an army of vegetable undead goat torsos. Or an extremely mean blood pump. We need the army. I actually need to think about this. This, the army thing, that kind of sounds like a Scott, something Scott would do. And Scott's right here. Write an extremely mean blog post. That's probably something Liam would do. So if I had to choose, and since we're focusing on Liam in this round, I'm going to say the blog post. That's a great idea. We'll do it right now.
Wait, Scott, I think you meant I should. But it's too late. Scott has already snatched Liam's laptop and started typing.
Mean words. Mean blog post. Grrr.
Not even ready to words. He's punching his laptop keyboard.
That's how you know the words you are mean. Because they're mad. Punching. Maybe punching.
Before Liam can get his computer back, Scott has already posted his fast speech against the immortal line.
I can think of.
Angus is strangely unmoved by this part. Essay and Liam's computer is small to the ruin. Liam might buy some smarts and buy some money in order to repair Liam's computer. Damn it. We should have went with the army, but I thought that was a Scott thing. I didn't realize the consequences of my actions. Anyway, we're gonna go to Liam and Beard. Take your seat beside Arnie, the two coolest monsters in all of Spooky High. Here's hoping you can keep up. Yes, they are indeed. I say this. Vera, are you eating Manticore steaks again? Yes. And it's delicious. Don't you know that the amount of cruelty involved in the mainstream meat production industry? Yes, and it's delicious. Besides, Liam, you're a vampire. Don't you only consume things that are dead? Well, yes, I suppose. But it's always ethically sourced, organic, free-range, and human. The human population is out of control, and eating them is the most environmentally responsible thing to do. Listen, Liam, I happen to have a personal feud with every single animal I eat. I make sure to meet all of them first and ensure I'm devouring only the ones I hate the most. Makes it extra tasty. Well, then, surely you can inflict such pain without going through the cruel meat industry and supporting factory farming. Isn't home cruelty better anyway? You may actually have a point there. If I make my hand in the pot, I can inflict even more effective and specific pain. I bet there's a way to make money off this too. Hang on. Somehow I've ended up arguing against my own interests here. Liam, do you want to find innovative and creative ways to move society forward? Or do you want to oppose cruelty like every other week to mainstream news? You can actually hear Liam's brain shaking as he struggles between his desire to be perceived as ethical and his desire to be perceived as creative. Maybe you can step in and help out. The animals you kill may live their lives, but what about their afterlives? Instead of letting their spirits go to waste as the byproduct of the meat industry, let's serve their eternal souls as a side dish. Liam, animals are already suffering from ignorance. If Vera wanted to increase their pain, the best would be to teach them the concept of death so they really appreciate it. Let's educate cattle on metaphysics. So, I can't condone animal cruelty, but I wholeheartedly support animal education. I do like animals, but their illiteracy is my fourth least favorite thing about them. I might be doing a poor taste in fashion and simplistic views on German cinema. Is that the worst idea you ever had? Although, face it, Robert, you are known for having pretty terrible ideas about 50% of the time. I didn't really see building an empire out of private schools for cattle, but with my business acumen, I guess it's possible. But I can rest secure in the knowledge that I'm solving the bovine education crisis. I'll be Liam helping cattle. It's like helping you help Liam choose you to go to prom with, or something. Okay. Alright, so we gotta make this last one count. The only place we went to the auditorium, we went to class, I went to the library, I haven't been outdoors, I've been to the gym, and I've been to the bathroom. Time to go outdoors. That day, during recess, you start a half-hour race that goes full crazy. You have no idea how it escalates so much, but at one point there are like 300 people. Someone summons demons from a ninth dimension. The consequences might disrupt the fabric of reality itself, but who cares? It's a rad party. You gain +2 fun. Casually reading the latest issue of Monster Magazine, we are rudely interrupted. See, even Roy, a sensible monster with a good head on his shoulders, and at least some smart, is reading Monster Mag. Is Scott an orange?
Yeah, that's bad, because we're warriors. So we need to fight.
Scott takes the magazine from you and punches it.
Hooray, let's go solve another of our major problems.
No, Scott, we're social justice. You see, Robbie, ever since I made a success with the Fangles, got head to bar, we've taken upon ourselves to stand up against injustice
by punching magazines.
No, Scott. As you no doubt know, Monster Magazine's the prettiest monsters alive this year is Count Victor von Musselmull, a werewolf prince slash bodybuilder. That makes him as the fifth royal werewolf bodybuilder in a row to earn the title. What about those of us supposed to learn leaner physiques? What a foul representation. So now we're endearing to get Monster Magazine to name someone from a more marginalized community as the sexiest creature alive.
We just need to figure out a way to convince them! So I guess punching the magazine was good enough.
That's easy. All you need is solving the problem. The issue forever is... Make your own version of the magazine featuring a three-winged... right on the cover. Lean heavily into the warrior part. Storm Monster Magazine. And hold the editor-in-chief captive until he promises to stop exclusively promoting one aesthetic at the pinnacle of monster. I don't know, guys. I can't focus because of Scott's stupid outfit. This last choice could count for my chance to go to the prom with Liam. I mean, this is more into like specific stuff, so Liam might like it, probably. Possible.
Oh yes, good plan. I love Fury Warrior.
I'll admit, it does sound like an attention-grabbing demonstration, if nothing else. Hot diggity dog, you're off the storm. The Monster Magazine headquarters. Using the element of surprise. Your second favorite element right after nitrogen. Your plan is to overpower Monster Magazine security and march straight into the editor-in-chief's office. But unfortunately, you're just a bunch of high schoolers. And even the talented high school athlete like Scott is a high school, and therefore you can match for highly trained security, pressure bodyguards. You get your butts totally handed up.
Oh, for like a warrior!
And this is not justice.
Sure isn't, but you destroyed society, justice, and warrior, and lost plus minus two fun as one charm.
Well, I've messed up. I don't even know if Damien wants to go with me to prom anymore. I mean, Liam, not Damien. Damien's this dude. We need to go, Liam. But, I mean, we can always try.
Okay. Ask Liam to the prom? Yes. I feel like this is gonna go terribly wrong. You finally pluck up the courage and ask your beloved to go on a monster prom with you.
You and me?
That'd be so predictable. Don't be a fool. Also, right now I only date blue inanimate objects. Don't harass me with your narrow mind and please respect my preferences. You're not sure. The right to marry your own hand, since that seems like your last chance of finding love.
Yay.
So apparently I'm about to high five, and Liam's quotes are so passionate. Well, that's basically my power and not the problem. I kinda suck at this game.
So yeah, that's Monster Prom. This has been my Halloween special, so thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like down below, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you don't miss an upload made by me. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.